The FM area, a live look from our Valley Skycam as you're looking at that setting sun and finally a little bit of sunshine, and temperatures not too bad either. It's been a little bit breezy, but it's those winds from the south that have helped bolster temperatures, which are right now working their way out of the 40s and back down into the 30s, 37 degrees. With that wind, it does feel a little bit on the chilly side out there with those wind chill values in the mid 20s for Fargo. Here's a look elsewhere. Temperatures today peaked only near 30 degrees along and north of Highway 2 as we melted some of that snow that amounted to anywhere from about an inch or two in Grand Forks to 5 to 8 inches along the northern tier of counties near the international border. 36 right now, Valley City, 38 Jamestown, 34 Fergus Falls and Wahpeton. Here's a look at the nation. Notice the cold pool of air diving all the way south into Oklahoma where they have 30s there. Cool pool of air, the coolest, starting to shift off toward the Great Lakes. That's allowing us to warm up, and that's exactly what happened today for us. Just a couple of clouds out there. Really, that wind, the story of the day, and the temperatures also the story of the day. And that wind is going to continue for your Friday evening. So if you are out and about tonight, be prepared for those south winds to continue at 10 to 25 miles per hour. In the far south, we could even see gusts higher than that, where Hutch has those bright arrows highlighted. Temperatures at bedtime sneaking down into the 20s for most of us. Then as we head through the overnight hours, those winds do a little bit of a shift. Now, instead of coming from the south, we'll see more of a westerly component to the wind, but still at 10 to 20 miles per hour through the night. Those winds help stir the atmosphere, and that keeps us from getting too cold too quickly. So it won't be too chilly tonight, with temperatures to start your weekend around 20 degrees. And then we'll say the heat is on. A few clouds passing overhead. Anywhere you see the green colors here, there'll be a chance at close to 40 degrees. We'll melt more snow along the northern tier, along and north of Highway 2. Temperatures are likely not 40, but still pretty pleasant as we head into the evening. It looks very quiet, minus a couple of clouds. And our winds tomorrow, westerly throughout the day, at between 10 and 20 miles per hour. So another breezy day and another above average day temperature-wise in Fargo, starting out at 27. We're going to jump 10 degrees by the midday hour, and we will spend some time in the low 40s out there, a mix of sun and clouds. And again, as far as the winds are concerned, west winds at 5 to 15 miles per hour, a little higher than that out to the west, as we'll see temperatures in the green areas reaching the 40-degree mark. And Grand Forks, you have a chance at that. We'll get rid of a little bit more snow, and you'll be zipping up into the 40s. Langdon, 35 for your afternoon, 33 Roseau. And out in Lakes Country for Detroit Lakes tomorrow afternoon, 37 degrees, a 35-degree day in Bemidji. Take a look at this gorgeous photo here. This one uploaded by Lisa in the Tolna area. Thanks so much, Lisa, for sharing your winter-like photo. Here is a look at Sunday. More warmth. Temperatures still in the 40s. And again, I think we'll be breezy. I can't rule out a spit or two of precipitation up north Sunday night into Monday. Doesn't look like a big deal, but we'll keep our eyes on that. Temperatures do cool off to start the work week just a little bit. I got an itch on my head. I don't know what that is. Oh, it's a turkey. Yeah, he's pecking at my head over there. Okay, at any rate, as we head towards Thanksgiving, we're talking about temperatures that will be a little bit cooler on Wednesday and into Thursday. And we will have some snow making its way through the region, particularly on Thursday and Friday. And the best chance of snow will be north, the way it's looking. We'll keep you posted. It doesn't look like a big, heavy hitting storm.
Okay.
But any snow for travelers on the holidays is something you need to be aware of.
Exactly. We'll watch for that. Thanks, Hutch.
You bet.